Well, hello and a very warm welcome to Daily Dispatch, a show that gives you all the latest news and updates from the digital ecosystem. I'm Priya Sheth. Thank you so much for logging in. Time now to get you all the top news stories that we've been tracking this evening. Well, OnePlus co-founder's consumer tech startup Nothing has raised about $15 million in a round led by GV. With this new funding, the company plans to expand its team, invest in R&D, as well as launch its first few products in the next few months. Now, Nothing has raised a total of about $22 million so far. Well, moving on to the second headline of the day, US-headquartered edtech startup SplashLearn has raised $18 million in a Series C funding round, which has been led by venture capital firm Owl Ventures. It also saw participation from Accel Partners. Now, the company plans to use this funding to scale up its personalized tutoring product. Well, Mahesh Bhupathi's direct-to-consumer beauty and wellness brand Sensuals has raised close to $6 million in funding from domestic PE firm TIW Private Equity. The company plans to use these funds to expand its product offerings as well as strengthen distribution. Well, moving on to the final headline of the day, gaming company Nazara Technologies has raised 100 crore rupees from Instant Growth Limited, which is advised by Hornbill Capital Advisors. Now, this funding comes ahead of its planned initial public offering. Do remember that Nazara Technologies had filed its DRHP with SEBI on the 14th of January. Now, this gaming company, which operates games like World Cricket Championship, says that it has invested over 300 crore rupees in the past 5 years in the game startup ecosystem.
We have with us Mr. Manish Agarwal from Nazara Technologies. Thank you very much for joining us today. And it's a big day for you because you've just raised about 100 crore rupees ahead of your IPO. Run us through how this fundraise came about and what does this really imply for Nazara Technologies?
See, from a Nazara's perspective, we welcome Hornbill Capital as who have really been gracious and nice to consider investing into Nazara. From our perspective, we are always eager to learn from people and learn from especially the investors who have scaled many companies in their portfolio working along with founders. So from our perspective, that is one key element which we are really looking forward to gain from the experience of the team, which is really joining the Nazara family, right? In terms of, if you look at the funds and fund utilization, Nazara is always has a historical track record of being EBITDA positive, has cash on balance sheet already. So from our perspective, this is an addition to the war chest for us to look at gaming and gaming market, gamified learning market, esports market, and how do we really grow in future. So we're very pleased. Who will not be pleased with the addition of some good investors who can really be around to be our counsel? So I think that's to me is a very positive move.
Just talk to us about the last year in terms of how the journey's been in 2020, because I do understand that the pandemic really changed the way people consume content, the way people actually are hooked onto their phones now at this point. So what has been your experience in terms of absolute growth? And, you know, if you could run us through what it means for Nazara going forward, is this a sort of, you know, a point where inflection point for the company?
See, I think it's an inflection point for the gaming industry, which I've been talking about saying that last 2 years. Or 2020 to 2030 is going to be golden age of gaming is all I've been really maintained. And if you look at it, the gaming is the a form of entertainment which has no entry price barrier. Everybody can really download a game and play without putting a single penny on the table. So that's the zero friction form of entertainment. And you are getting a great rush of dopamine because you feel happy about yourself when you have scored something. Now, while you can passively watch videos, when you're playing gaming, your self-worth improves, and that's the best thing which can happen, right? And from there, that's where this entertainment format, I believe, is going to be really, really very big in India because there is zero friction. I feel nice about myself. I also get entertainment. What more do you ask for? right? And events like COVID accelerated the adoption on three counts. One, more number of gamers. Second, more time spent being on gaming. And third is more social multiplayer gaming happening, which made it makes it like a social community platform. What is the implication of the third one is very important. It broad bases the engagement across demographic segments. So it is not that I'm playing a PUBG, it's a 18-year-old boy playing against 18-year-old boy. Now it is about couples hanging out together with other couples who love to play PUBG. And that is what is the gaming brings. It brings these social interactions, a multiplayer. And that's what I think is really very, very nice, which has happened and will continue to be accelerated in India as we come along. From a Nazara's perspective, I think we have been really looking at last 3 years and working on identifying key segments and areas which were having a natural momentum. Whether it's the growth of esports, where people will love to watch people playing video games, that is a natural phenomenon. There are sports fans who will watch any sports. The underlying game may change, but the spectator sports will be the same. Similarly, the secular trend of education, learning becoming fun is going to happen, and learning happening on devices is going to happen. So we had spotted that trend and we said that let's kind of drive that. Similarly, people will love to play virtual cricket, virtual soccer. FIFA has been around. We took that thing of people will have virtual cricket and they will simulate it exactly the way they play. And now they will like to compete in a 1-to-1 kind of a format where they are playing a multiplayer game. So for us, these are the trends which we had looked at 3 years back and been working to build that platform of large consumer existing behaviors. How will they transition in the virtual world? And we have just taken that, seen that growth of them happening. The pace of acceleration of adoption has really increased, but the momentum had already been there. Just that gaming has become mainstream for a lot of media. And hence, suddenly, this question is being posed to us, right? Otherwise, this was already happening. And I'm glad that now you guys are also realizing it. And I can give you my two cents.
In terms of trends, in terms of which are the trends or the segments which will sort of see increase in momentum?
If you look at the segments, right, as I said, intrinsic consumer behavior, whether spectator sports being driven by video games, whether learning happening through apps, or whether virtual cricket experience simulation happening, they're all going to grow. Right. So I do not have doubts saying that one segment will grow lesser and more. It's the consumer segment trend which will continue to grow. How will that pan out in terms of user base? How will it pan out in terms of revenue? How will it pan out in terms of profitability? I think that's where I'll have to draw a line in terms of how much can I talk about it, how much I can't talk about.
Right, you know, in fact, this year has been a very momentous year for gaming startups. At this point, have you seen the kind of funding that's coming in? How did you, there are some who are struggling, there are some who've got it very easy and have got funds right away. So how do you pitch the overall landscape?
I don't think any gaming company you speak to or any gaming founder you speak to, and he will tell you the funds have come easy. I can really vouch on that, right? Gaming is the most difficult area to really build business because two kids or two youngsters can also make a game, right? Entry barriers are very low. It requires amazing amount of perseverance, conviction, passion to really make it a success. Getting into gaming is easy, making it success is very difficult, right? So it is not an easy for any gaming company whatsoever to really raise funds. It's a question of what is that you have created, and how are you able to kind of demonstrate or tell your story, which excites one person? And you have to find that one person, and you may have to knock one door or you may have to knock 100 doors, but your if you have created something and you're able to communicate it, you will be able to get somebody to fund you, back you.
You know, I can't let you go without playing a quick game with you, considering that this is a conversation that we're having. So are you ready? This is going to be a quick three-question rapid fire. You're
tricking me into a blind game.
We can't let you go without this game. So I'm going to ask you, and you have to be as quick as possible. All right? Okay. So Nazara Technologies, 10 years down the line.
One of the largest global gaming company.
Okay. Your favorite game as a child?
My favorite game was Ludo. Yeah.
And a last question on which is your biggest strength and your biggest weakness?
I trust people, and that's the strength and weakness both.
All right. On that note, many thanks for joining us today for this very interesting conversation, and wish you all the very best for your upcoming IPO. Thank you for joining us on the Daily Dispatch.
Thanks, Priya. Thank you.
Well, time now to say goodbye. Many thanks for joining us on this edition of Daily Dispatch. I'll see you tomorrow at 5 p.m. Goodbye and see you tomorrow.